tonight I decided to cook Japanese sushi. So I'm inviting you with me on a wonderful, magical trip to the Japanese kitchen. And tonight on my menu gonna be sushi Philadelphia roll and tuna roll. This rice is bought at Asian store, and at the package you will find direction how to cook it right. Rice should be cooked really proper because it's so important for sushi to be right. When rice is cooked, we take 50 grams of special vinegar, also for rice. You can find it at a Japanese store as well, which is very important. 50 grams on 500 grams. Also, we need 3 teaspoons of sugar and 1 teaspoon of salt. And we mix it all. Now we're putting it on sushi. On a rice. When our rice is ready to use, we start to make our sushi mat. For that, we take sushi mat and cover it with the plastic wrap. We just covered our mat with the plastic wrap. I did it pretty tight, so I removed all the air. Next step. I give you one trick, which I think really important. We take olive oil. And put it on the mat. I tell you why. It helps for rice not to stuck on the mat. So eventually you will have much easier and more enjoyable time to cook sushi. My dear folks, when we are done with mat, we remove it on the side and we start preparing fish. For that, I'm taking napkins and I'm using some good surface, which is wooden one. It's pretty good and convenient. I place napkins for the fish not to you put juice on the surface. I'm using this and I practically cover it to make it clean. I'm taking salmon. Salmon. My favorite salmon. And I suggest to use very good knives, sharp ones. Sharp knives are very important because we don't have a second chance. So we use sharp knives. And most important, try to slide the fish pretty thin, this kind of way. We're not in a hurry, we do everything slowly, slowly. I'm excited a lot, you know why? Because I'm gonna cook my first Philadelphia roll ever. Before this evening, I used to eat Philadelphia rolls at restaurants. But COVID helped me to realize how important to cook home. And tonight is a special night when I cook my first Philadelphia roll and eat it in front of you, my dear followers. Yes. So let's go. Let's get started. We take wheat. Seaweed. Place it on the mat. We take sushi. We take rolls. And gonna be like that. I like it like that. Important detail. When we cook sushi, we use water in case rice doesn't stick to fingers. Water helps us to remove it. We use water and it helps us easier to place rice. When we place rice gently on a lid, we need to make it straight a little bit. So watch what I'm doing with my fingers. I'm doing like that. You see? Huh? So now I show you a trick. This trick I'm doing the first time in my life, so I'm scared. I need your support. We need to turn it upside down, okay? 1, 2, 3. Oh! Almost done! Woohoo! I did it! Okay, I move it. Great. It was pretty exciting. Okay, you see what I did? I left a little bit over the wheat rice. And here also I have 2 centimeters more not covered with rice. Now we're ready to put some good ingredients inside. Since I'm cooking Philadelphia roll, I'm putting cucumber, which I cut on the strips like that. So watch out. Some cucumber. Accent. Cucumber placed. I'm placing avocado because I love it. Now we're placing Philadelphia cheese. I heat up Philadelphia cheese in microwave, so it was more smooth. And after I put it into a particular cooker, usually people use it to decorate cakes, but I decided to make sushi in it. So watch. You can find this at a place, is Asian stuff. Or is a cooking place where you cook cakes stuff. And now I'm placing Philadelphia cheese. Now when I placed avocado, when I placed cucumber, I placed cucumber, avocado and Philadelphia cheese, I'm gonna cover it with my favorite fish caviar. I'm taking a red one. You know what good news is? At home, you can put as much as you want. So I put a lot. So now, we are about to roll our roll. Okay. Whew. We cover it like that. Guys, I only realized that I'm making huge extra sushi. You know why? I forgot to cut wheat. I'm sorry. It's my first sushi, really, I swear. But for you, very important detail. When you get a standard wheat, just cut it. Cut it like that, on a half. So you will not have at the end a huge sushi like I do. Okay, our roll is not like almost Philadelphia roll because there is one missing, and this is salmon. So we take salmon and place it on a dish. Okay, I'm gonna cut it on half. Cut it again on the half. And again on the half. Okay, my sushi is ready and I'm about to try it. Oh, I'm kind of nervous. My first sushi at home. I cook myself with you. Thank you for your help. Okay. The one inconvenient moment about my sushi is the
pretty too big. I honestly don't know how I'm gonna fit it into my mouth, but I try. Can I put in wasabi? Little bit of lemon. Oh my god, I thought it was gonna be easy. Oh, so good. Really good. Oh my god. I must say, even though it's first time, but I did pretty well. Bravo to me. And my dear followers, I really hope your first sushi gonna be better than mine. And if for some reason it will not work first time, remember, Natalie also did a few mistakes, so don't hesitate to start trying doing sushi home. Subscribe under my channel because new videos gonna arrive very soon. And thank you for your time.